The section is called Subordinate Your Ego. Which is a good phrase. Powerful phrase. And I actually go through a pretty detailed example of when I had to subordinate my own ego and how that helped solve this certain problem. And I end up kind of going into an explanation of what the ego is, how it's playing out granularly. Here we go. Back to the book. Ego is like reactive armor. The harder you push against it, the more it pushes back. Do I get some good credit for that one? Yeah. That is
the tankers out there ought to appreciate that.
That is exactly. So true.
Yes.
Someone that's got an ego, like, you might not even notice it until you brush up against it, then all of a sudden it reacts. Continues on. If I had confronted the CEO, and that goes back to the story, if I had confronted the CEO about his attitude and told him he had a big ego, he would have dug in even deeper. So I did the opposite. I disarmed his ego by subduing my own. Now, this is why I wanted to bring this up today. You might be afraid that if you subordinate your ego, you will get trampled. But that normally doesn't happen, because subordinating your ego is actually the ultimate form of self-confidence. And I think that line right there is one of the lines when I was writing this book, I just like took a screenshot of it and texted it to you, Dave. I was like, that line right there.
Yeah.
Because subordinating your ego is actually the ultimate form of self-confidence. That level of confidence earns respect. So while the initial thought or feeling might be that you back down, you've actually shown that you have the strength and confidence to give the other person credit, and they will recognize and respect that confidence either consciously or subconsciously. They feel it. Echo Charles, when you're getting ready to roll jiu-jitsu, mm-hmm. and you have never rolled with this person before, and you lock up with them, you know, right? You can feel it. Now, yes. Whether you want to admit it or not, you know.
Yeah.
And that's what this does. When someone says, hey, you know what? Go ahead and run with that. And Dave might think, well, that's right. That's right. I'm going to run with it because my plan is better. And in the back of his mind, he thinks, man.
Yeah.
Like when someone says, oh, you want to start a cross-side? That's basically what you're saying. Okay. You want to start in a dominant position? Go ahead. It's fine. It's fine with me. I'm so confident in my jiu-jitsu that you can basically start anywhere. You can start in a totally dominant position and I'm going to be fine. Mm-hmm. When you subdue your ego, when you subordinate your ego, that person, you might be thinking, I'm going to start on the mat and I'm going to kill you.
Yeah.
And you think that, right? And you feel powerful. But in the back of your mind, you're thinking, maybe subconsciously you're thinking, wow, this person is confident. This person knows that they're going to win.
Yeah.
And so that's the same thing that happens here. Hey, you know what? Why don't you go ahead and run with this? And you go, yeah, that's right, I won. And in the back of your mind, you think, man, Jocko doesn't even really, he doesn't even care where this ends up.
The word subordinate is such a good word, because when you tell people to check your ego, it's like, okay, I can check my ego. But if you're the type of person that reads the word subordinate and it bothers you, you are the person that's being spoken to right now, because your ego says, I am not going to subordinate, because it's submissive, or it has this feeling of, that's why that word is actually so good, because most of us don't want to do that.
No.
I don't like that word subordinate. I don't want to subordinate. I don't want to be submissive or passive or... That word is awesome, because if you feel yourself right now reading that going, I don't like that, read this again and again, and because it's actually what you need to do.
And check this out. If you're reading this and you're going, I don't want to subordinate my ego because I'm powerful, then read the next part, which says, if you're truly powerful, you got no problem doing it.
This doesn't concern you at
all. Hey, you know what? I don't need to be the star of the show. Because I'm just going to be over here, and it's going to be fine. You guys can you can pay attention to the other guys. That's cool. I'll be over here. And I'm good with that. I don't need to say anything. I don't need to start in the best position. I'm good. I'm confident. I've been doing this game for a long time. We're good. It continues on. So after I say either they will recognize and respect that confidence either consciously or subconsciously, it says, and that is the truth. To put your ego in check, to subordinate your ego, you must have incredible confidence. If you find you cannot put your ego in check because you're afraid it might look might make you look weak, then guess what? You are weak. Don't be weak. Subordinate your ego, build relationships, and win the long game. That's a pretty important chapter, dude, in this book.
That's huge. I mean, that gets to the core of what infects almost everything we do. There almost isn't a problem in the world that exists in your life that isn't connected to your ego. And that is the lesson for that. And the amazing thing about that is that not only are you strong if you can do that, you just start winning everywhere. Yeah, you just start winning everywhere in life. You just start winning when you do that. When you look around and go, oh, no, no factor, go for it, do that.
Yep.
You win. Life gets so much better when you're able to do that.
Just let it go. And the supreme confidence. This is the weird part. This is what people don't understand. The supreme confidence that exudes when you go, oh, you want to take lead on this? Cool, go for it. Cool.
Yeah. What can I do to help?
Yeah. What can I do to support you? Sounds like you got this handled. What can I do to help? The supreme confidence that exudes is powerful. Kind of like when someone gets in your head on the map, right?
Yes.
Yeah, when they go, cool, you can start wherever you want, bro.
I'll tell you an even more powerful moment. Smaller, it's seemingly smaller, mm-hmm. but it's way more powerful when you think about it. So let's say me and you are rolling, mm-hmm. right? And then you, let's say I get a good position on you, mm-hmm. right? And you, and then we sort of drift, let's say I get mount, whatever, great position on you. And we sort of, we're scrambling, whatever, I still got mount. And then we kind of drift out of bounds, right? Mm-hmm. Or we run into somebody or whatever, where we got to kind of stand up, you know, get out of the jiu-jitsu position, stand up and walk to a clear part on the mat. And then, so, because that'll happen sometimes, and the person in the bad position will just sort of clap your hand like you're starting all over.
Oh, yeah, that's even, yeah.
You see what I'm saying? For you know, sure. They'll be like, oh, yeah, we're
I was going to say resetting. Maybe a small adjustment. Maybe I like, oh, we're going, like, yeah. You're mounted, but I got my elbow already in, so right. It's going to be okay.
But that's a little bit more sneaky.
Yeah.
It's probably just as sneaky, but just in a different way. It's a different thing in a little bit of way.
Well, they're both going to send the same message.
Yeah,
I'm but, scared.
But this, exactly right. So here's,
I'm
but,
not confident.
Yeah, exactly right. So let's go one step further. So let's say we roll. I get into a good position on you. We go back to the center of the thing. You slap my hand and you get into like the neutral position, mm-hmm. right? And it's like a little dance. You know, someone's going to lead this and lead that, right? So you slap my hand, we get into a neutral position. The confident guy will just be like, cool, we're in a neutral position now. Yeah, cool. Yeah. And we just keep rolling.
Oh, yeah. The unconfident
guy. Wait, I had mount. Oh, I had mount. No, let's go back to mount. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Even though he'd still be justified, but the supremely confident man.
Supremely confident. That's it. Fly. Oh, cool. Yeah. I'll tell you what. Why don't you mount me?
Don't say anything. Just be like, whatever. Yeah, this is cool. What we're doing. I don't need attention to let you know that that's how supremely confident I am. You know, you see what I'm saying? Like I'm so confident. I go ahead, mount. I'll let it slide. You know, I don't even have to say that. Just do it, whatever.
Be that guy.
Be that guy, 100%.